All right, we got a fish. Ooh, what is this? Is this a lake trout or a big walleye? Oh! Ooh! Guys, welcome back. My name is Jay Siemens. I live in a place where we have winter like 6 months of the year. From November till April, we can be on the ice. And right now there's a fish swimming towards my jig. We're on Lake of the Woods. We're trying for lake trout. The sun has almost set, but I'm just starting now. Why are you just starting now? Well, I just finished filming my goodness! I just finished filming another project for Leatherman Canada. It just wrapped up and I still had some time left in the day. So I thought, hey, let's see if we can make a little YouTube video. So it's probably gonna be, you know, pretty basic. Couple cameras, one on my chest, one on the tripod, live scope cam. And it's just gonna be you and me hanging out in the shack. Maybe catching a lake trout. I don't know what these fish are we're marking near the bottom. Nice size marks. Oof. What is this? Is this a leaker? Oh, it keeps bumping me. All right, we're switching to a rattle bait. This is a bait by Element Custom Painting. I'm not actually sure what type of rattle bait it is, but I know it's custom painted. Play that little shiner pattern right there. The lighting's probably kind of tough. Very natural looking. Yeah, should be able to rattle up a lake, or hopefully. We got about an hour till sunset and I'm feeling good. All right, we are rattling. This might be a laker. What do we got? Oh, we bumped it. I don't think that was a laker. I think it was too small to be a laker. Fish coming in. Looks like a decent sized mark. All right, here we go. Here we go. Not doing anything too violent. He's coming in nicely. Just gonna kind of pound on the spot a bit. He doesn't react nicely. There we go. I'm thinking not a lake trout. I'm thinking walleye. And if it is a walleye, we're gonna keep it because we're a little bit too deep to release him here. That is a beautiful walleye. Perfect eater. Kind of crazy lighting on that custom painted Element rattle bait. First time using it. It's just gonna happen when you're laker fishing that you're gonna catch probably perch, walleye mixed in, and their stomachs will pop out. So, I mean, you may as well keep them at that point. If you're using medium to smaller size baits, it's gonna happen. You can't get around it. Ooh, I think there's a laker coming in, guys. Look at this on the left. So I'm watching my Cisco. See if he comes in for that, but he's kind of slithering on the bottom right now. Look at that mark on the left. Look at this mark on the left, guys. Come on. Come in, buddy. So like I said, Cisco lane on the left. If I see, oh, he's gonna eat the Cisco. Oh, he's gonna eat the Cisco. Did he eat it? Two Lakers. Oh my goodness. Look at this. Oh, oh no, he just ate it. He just ate it. Okay, he's peeling line. He just ate the Cisco off the bottom. Oh, guys, we just started. And the action, there was two Lakers. See them come in there? I'm just gonna let this guy swim for a little bit. I'm gonna get this other bait out of the water. Pandemonium. Oh no, I'm tangled. Okay, that one's out. That Laker still has it. I'm gonna pull up my live scope transducer too. That fish is still screaming line. All right, are you guys ready for this? That was a good start to the video. Sun is setting, it's prime time. And we're hooked up with a Laker. Yes. Oh baby, I just lost. Nope, I thought I just lost it. Ooh. Oh no, we're still hooked. Gotta open my bail. I'm still hooked in the jig over there. This is gonna get interesting. Whew, we haven't moved this fish too much yet. Seeing those two fish swimming together on LiveScope was so cool. That's what I've said about LiveScope, is it's so cool for learning, right? You learn how those fish interact, and I wasn't envisioning two trout. Once you see it on LiveScope, it makes it real, right? This is the running gun. This is the 50 inch medium. I've got a 4,000 size Stradic with a ton of 40 pound braid. And then I tied a 25 pound fluorocarbon leader with a quick strike rig. I'm gonna show you guys the rigging before this video is over. This fish is just sitting. It's heavier than I thought. Wow. Ooh, this fish is heavy. Guys. It's like a minus 45 wind chill outside. And that's why, you know, you could set a tip up, but it's pretty tough to deal with fish outside. That's why I laid the one dead bait and then I was jigging the active rod right beside it. And obviously not as good for covering water, but on a day like this, do what you gotta do. Sorry to interrupt you in the middle of a fish fight. I know that's very rude, but we're taking this time to go over rigging, rods, reels, line, on how to bait fish for lake trout, because it is, as you can see, a pretty effective method. So first off, let's go over rods. I don't think there's one perfect rod. I think it depends on, you know, the size of the fish you're targeting and the size of baits you're using. So we're gonna kind of start at the lightest end of the spectrum and go up. Starting on the lighter end of the spectrum, this is the 50 inch run and gun. This is what I'm fighting the fish on currently. This rod is the softest rod I would probably use for something of lake trout this size, but you can see it's got a really nice smooth bend kind of all the way through. Doesn't, not an insane amount of backbone, but like totally fine for this type of fish. So it's a 50 medium. Next up, this is probably my favorite all around trout rod. This is a 43 heavy. This is the Mr. Big, as you can see. Like it still has a soft tip, but a lot more backbone than that last rod, but still, it's not all tip, so you can still fight a fish and keep him pinned. You don't necessarily, like, you still want that fish to be able to shake its head and, you know, the rod absorb the head shakes. And then my big boy, and complete transparency, I have not caught a fish on this, I've barely used it yet. This is the Slugger, and this is made for, you know, the north, for northern Manitoba, for huge lake trout, and for laying big baits on the bottom. If you're using some bigger hooks, and you're dealing with 40 plus inch trout, and you're gonna be laying like a full tulipy on the bottom, this is gonna be the rod for you. You could also use this for, you know, big tube jigs if you're not bait fishing, but this is the Slugger, the 46 extra heavy. All right, next we're gonna go over reels. All right guys, so as far as line goes and reels, I like using spinning reels. I know you could be using a bait caster, if you're using a bait casting type rod as well, that's fine. On the smaller side, this is probably the smallest reel I'd use. This is like a 3000 size spinning reel. All right, and then on the biggest side, like all the way up to a 5000 size reel, like this is what I'd use for tarpon in the ocean. But all these rods and reels I'm using are the same thing you'd probably want to use for big pike if you're, you know, using an iFish Pro or just laying the bait and the rod beside you. But biggest thing is a large arbor reel is gonna hold a lot of line. If you have a 1000 size reel and you're using 40 pound braid, it's gonna spool that line very quick because it's thicker diameter, it won't be that much line. So I would say don't go smaller than a 2500 size reel. 3000, 4000 size is great. You can go up to a 6000 size. Like this rod is 65 pound braid on it, which is really heavy, but it's just one less thing you worry about when you're fighting the fish. You have heavy line. If you're using a tip up, you're using, you know, 80 pound line often. So putting 65 pound braid on, isn't that crazy? So yeah, as far as line as a whole, I'm looking at the lightest 20 pound braid if you're fishing for smaller lakers, and then all the way upwards of 50 to 65 pound braid. Next, we're gonna talk about the leader material, which is also gonna lead into the rigging. These are kind of my two options right here that I use for leader material. You got some 25 pound Seaguar right there, some 20 pound Trilene 100% fluorocarbon, whatever. I would go anywhere from 15 to a 30 pound leader, depending on the size of the baits you're using. Yeah, I think if you just need one rod that can kind of cover the spectrum for bait fishing for pike and lake trout, I'd probably go like with that 43 heavy with a 3000 size reel, 30 pound braid somewhere in there, and then 20 or 25 pound leader. But we're gonna switch to the top down view, and I'm gonna show you the rigging. This is called a quick strike rig. And the point of this rig is that you can set the hook quickly. Sometimes you do wanna let that fish, you know, take it for a minute to position the bait in their mouth, but this isn't the type of thing where you let the fish eat it and you wait for 5 minutes, 10 minutes. You're able to, as soon as the fish has a position in his mouth, you set the hook, and the whole point is you're not gonna gut hook that fish. Obviously there are exceptions always, that is a potential, but I mean, as long as you're on the ball, it shouldn't be an issue. So we're gonna look at some treble hooks. I'm gonna show you what I look for in a treble hook, and then we're gonna tie up just a homemade quick strike rig. All right guys, so here is a finished rig that you can see against my hand, if that focuses nicely. So as you can see, two treble hooks tied to the fluorocarbon leader. Obviously this isn't good for pike because they could bite right through, but for lake trout, it's perfect. I think a common mistake is people just using hooks a little bit on the big side. First thing we're gonna do is we need to connect this to our leader line. We're using 20 pound fluorocarbon here. Line to line knots can be a little bit intimidating. So if you wanna do a line to line knot, you can use an FG knot, a uni to uni knot, Alberto knot. Those are kind of the three, I would say, most popular options. But that being said, if you don't feel comfortable, just get yourself a swivel, a micro swivel, and that's what we're gonna tie with today. It's rated for 80 pounds. They're super small, they go through your eyelets easily. The only problem you may have is it may hook on your reel right at the line roller, but other than that, you know, it's just a peace of mind, because if you're not confident with line to line knots, you know, practice it at home, but a swivel does the job too. So as you can see, these are some micro swivels right there. All right, so we're gonna tie a uni knot onto the swivel here. Always pass it through twice when you're dealing with a braided line. 1, 2, 6, 7. Take our fluoro over here. And here you only need to pass it through once at the start of your uni knot. Get it wet. And it'll slide together. So we're gonna trim this up and I'll show you how. It's pretty clean. All right, so there's a nice strong line to line connection there. As you can see, tiny little swivel that'll help with line twist as well. If your bait's, you know, spinning on the way down, spinning on the way up. This is also a great way if you're tying, you know, spoons, any sort of jigging bait. If you put a swivel in, it'll help with that line twist. So right now, you wanna determine how long your leader is. And if you're fishing in a super clear lake, this leader might be 15, 20 feet long. The fish can be spooky. So we can just keep letting line out, keep going, whatever. It can be real long because this bait's gonna be laying on the bottom. You don't want that big yellow beacon right above him. So I don't know, it's probably 15 feet. First thing we're gonna do is just tie a uni knot here. Normally, like you'd just be tying a single treble. Once again, you should wet it. There you go, trim that up. All right, there's treble number one. I really like these triple grip type hooks. They're just really sharp. They have a nice bend. I feel like I don't lose too many fish on them. Cater your hook size to the size bait you're using, right? You don't want it to overpower. And the big thing is when you hook that into your bait, you want it to rip out of the bait and into the fish's mouth. So this next step is probably the more difficult step. And this is kind of what turns it from just normal treble hook into a quick strike rig. So we're gonna cut off another chunk of line here. We can favor a little bit longer. All right, so this is how we're gonna connect that second hook. So there's two ways we can connect that second hook. We can tie to the shank of it, or we can tie to the eyelet. Either way works. I think tying to the shank, just everything flows a little bit nicer. You don't put any weird angles of the line there. So we're gonna tie, whatever knot you use, but we're gonna tie a uni knot around the shank here. Same knot we've been using. Make it wet, and that's gonna slide right up. So now this is the point. Depending on the size of your bait, you need to determine how long you want that tag to be. If you're using, you know, a 12 inch bait, you probably want one near the head and one near the tail. So whichever way the fish grabs it, you get some hooks. If you're using a smaller Cisco, you might want to make it, you know, a little bit shorter. We're going to just make it, kind of an average size. If that's an 8 inch gap from my pinky to my thumb, we're probably going to make a 5 inch gap. So we're going to obviously leave a little extra here. So we have some room to tie our knot. And then, so we've got it tied to the shank. Same deal here, tying in it. It can take a little bit of finesse now to, you know, get that right leader length. All right, so now we've tied that second hook in. We're gonna kind of just help slide that knot along. And there we go, that second knot slid. I'm gonna trim those tag ends. Let's clean up all this junk on the table so you can see what we're dealing with. And there you have a quick strike rig. Like, so easy to tie. That line is not coming off the bend of the hook, especially if you can fish barbed. But even if you can't fish barbed, like, a fish is never going to be pulling that direction if you're pulling this direction with your rod, if that makes sense. So yeah, tying onto the bend is super great. If that makes you nervous, I've never had an issue with it, you could tie it onto the eyelet as well. But right there, that's perfect for a, you know, 5-6 inch bait. And the thing is, with Lakers, I love to set the bait on the bottom. It's going to be laying on the bottom, so it doesn't matter how the hooks hold that fish because the bait's laying on the bottom. If I'm building a quick strike rig for a pike, if I'm trying to, you know, hang a pike bait, I might want it to hang horizontal. So hook placement matters a little bit more if it's in the middle of the body or not. But with laying a bait on the bottom, two treble hooks, and it's pretty deadly. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna show you one more time. As you can see, two treble hooks, and that swivel, it just reeled right into the reel, no problem. And yeah, it's a lot easier than a line to line knot if that makes you uncomfortable. And yeah, I think it works great. So there you have a quick strike rig. All right, guys, there you go. Some options on rigging. This is what I like to do. It's not necessarily the right way, but yeah, there's some background on rods, reels, line, and how to make your own quick strike rig. So all the hooks, line, all that stuff will be linked in the description, but we gotta get back to the action. With those two treble hooks on the quick strike rig, I just have a lot of confidence on, you know, that fish staying pinned. And you just gotta wait. There's no reason to like put a ton of pressure on it because you just don't want to tear those hooks out. It's not going anywhere. Ooh, it's getting closer. When it does those quick cuts by the hole, it's probably the coldest day of the year and I decided to go ice fishing. Go figure. Look at that bend. Oh baby, oh baby. This is not a small fish. Yep. I'm gonna see if I can reel it in. to get that out of the way. Yes, yes, we got the rattle bait out. Success. All right, this fish is close. We need to get its head guided up the hole. This is the scariest part. Oh, that's a nice big laker. Come on, baby. All right, we're gonna get our tools ready. All right, guys, I'm gonna keep this fish in the water as long as I can. We got a grip on her. All right, guys, I don't care if I get another bite tonight. Look at that for the first trout of the night. That is awesome. Such a good fight. All right, we're gonna get it back. She fought hard. And yeah, just, you gotta take your time reviving these big old fish. She kicked hard. All right, I just fell into the hole. That was so good, oh my goodness. All right, guys, this is the quick strike rig that I was talking about. That's what did the damage, and this is what we're using for bait. This is a Cisco. This is like perfect laker size. I don't know, 5 inches, 6 inches. All right, so this is how we're doing it. It doesn't really matter how the fish sits in the water because you're gonna lay it on the bottom. Lake trout do like to eat baits off the bottom. So right now I'm just putting those two small treble hooks right in the back of him there. Guys, if you are gonna bait fish for lake trout, you need to be prepared to deal with that fish. Is make sure you got some long pliers, some tool to get the hook out, because you're not just gonna cut the line and leave the hooks in there, right? Sometimes they do take them a little bit deeper, and you have to be prepared to be able to take them out and release that fish, right? This is, you're not gonna keep a fish like that to eat. You're gonna release it, and you wanna just do everything you can to stack the odds in your favor. Lake trout do have the ability to burp. So if you are catching them in deeper water, as you could see, there was bubbles coming up, and that's him expelling his air bladder. White fish can burp as well. So that's why they fish for those types of fish deeper. But yeah, it can be a really effective way. You just gotta, you know, make sure, you know, there's a little more chance of hooking that fish deep than just with a single tube jig or something like that, right? So you need to have the proper tools and make sure it's legal where you're at, right? Because some places it's single hook barbless and don't want to get caught with a bunch of treble hooks down there. Well, guys, the truck is running. Nothing really happened for the last few hours, but hey, at least we got that good one right at the start. I hope this video taught you a little bit about bait fishing for lakers. It's a great way to utilize your second line. And you know, some days smash the fluke right away. The next day they want that bait laying on the bottom. Got to make sure have the proper gear, have a heavy rod, heavy line, proper release tools. Putting these fish back healthy is so important. If you guys have any other questions, please comment them below. Thank you guys for watching, and we will catch you on the ice very soon.